So we have the question number 29. We are trying to solve the problems in ESLA, which corresponds to SR, single random variable. And within that, from the expectations, we'll try to solve the numericals. Because if you see over here, this just corresponds to the, you know, expectations, right? 2.4 expectation onwards, 29 problem, we'll try to solve. So the problem clearly says that the PDF for the random variable y is given by this. We need to find the mean, we need to find the mean of the square, we need to find the variance of the random variable y. So mean will be just variable is y over here. So y f y y integral minus infinity to infinity y f y y is what we need to find out. So if you try to find out that mu y is equal to y f y y y dy minus infinity to infinity, where this is the PDF. So PDF is given to us, we are just putting it there, 1.5 1 minus y square dy. So we are separating it out, 1.5 y dy and 1.5 y into y square, that is y cube dy. So having taken that, the integral of y is y squared by 2 with limits 0 and 1. Integral of y cube is y to the power 4 divided by 4 with limit 0 to 1. So limit 1 will give me 1, limit 0 will give me 0. So if for y square as well as y to the power 4. So that will be effectively 1.5 by 2 minus 1.5 by 4. So that will give us the value 0.375. Then we have the mean of the squares. That will be y square fy y dy, that is equal to y square 1.5 1 minus y square dy. So again separating it out, 1.5 y square dy minus 1.5 y to the power 4 dy with an integral. So now if you integrate this with same limits 0 and 1, 1.5 y cube y 3. I have not put the limits here, 0 to 1, 1.5 y to the power 5 y 5 with the limits again 0 to 1. So if you put those limits, then we'll, you know, have again 1.5 by 3 minus 1.5 by 5, that will give us the 0.2 value. So therefore the variance which is there here will be equal to the expectation of x square minus the, you know, mean square, that will give 0.2 minus 0.375 square, and that will be the value which is 0.059375. Then we have the 32, let us see what it is. So if you see here 30, 31, they are just similar to the 29. So hence we don't solve that. You can try to solve that, and if you don't get the solution, you can just inform me. Okay, 32 is what we have here. So in the 32, we have 1 by 8 z minus 6. For all values of z between 6 to 10 and 0, otherwise mean, mean of the square, variance of the random variable. Okay. So mu z is equal to z f z z minus infinity infinity dz equal to again 6 to 10 z, in place of f z z we should write 1 by 8 z minus 6 dz, 1 by 8 z minus 6 dz. That will be the value of the, you know, fzz, that is what is given to us. So again you can separate it out. So this will become z square by 8, then the other one will become 6 by 8 into z. So if you integrate this over here, we'll get z cube by 3 into 8, that is z cube by 24 with limits 6 and 10. This is 6 by 8 is the constant. The integral of z is z squared by 2 with limits 6 and 10 again. So therefore, here it will be 10 cubed minus 6 cubed by divided by 24 minus 3 by 8, 10 square minus 6 square. So this will be 784 divided by 24, right? And that will give us, you know, minus 3 by 8 into 10 square minus 6 square, that will give you 100 minus 36 equal to 64. So 8 will cancel with 8. So this will become 24, and this will become 784 by 24 will be 32.66. Hence, we'll get 8.67 as the mean value. To find the variance, we need to find the mean of the square, that is E of Z square. So procedure is just the same, only that you have Z square here. All the other steps are just the same. Okay, hence you'll get here 10 to the power of 4 minus 6 to the power of 4 divided by 32. 32 because again, you know, value of Z to the power of 4 will get denominator. So therefore, this will become 32. And this will be 6 by 8 into 3. 8 into 3 is written as 24. And Z cube is 10 cube minus 6 cube. So if you solve that, you'll get the value which is known as 76 for E of X square. So sigma z square will be 76 minus 8.67 square. That will give us the value which is 0.8888 or just 0.89. Then we come to the 35. Let us see the problem number 35. So again, if you see 33, 34 are similar problems to the 32. Hence, we are not solving. Try to solve that and see the answer which is at the end of the book. Then 35 is what we will take here. Given EX equal to 2.0 and EX square is equal to 6, find standard deviation. And if Y is equal to, you know, such a big number, then find the mean of that Y. So sigma X square is EX square minus mu X square. And that will give us 6 square, 6 minus 2 square, and that will give 2. Therefore, standard deviation, which is sigma x, is plus root 2 equal to plus 1.414. Then the mean of the y variable, where y is written as 6x square plus 2x minus 13. So for that, you have to take out 6 common e of x square, 2 common e of x minus 13. So totally, if you just substitute the value of e x square and e of x, then you'll get this as 6 into 6, 36, 14. 36 plus 4 will be 40. 40 minus 13 will be 27. I think I might have made a mistake that I would have written 17 in the last class. Just check that. Okay. Then question number 40. So just now we did 35. Similarly, 36, 37, same. Right, 38 also is almost same. 39 is again almost same. So I'm not doing all that. We go to 40. Okay, so similar to 40 is 39 and 38. So I'm solving one of them, which is 40. Okay. So mean is given, standard deviation is given. So variance will be double of this. So we need to find squared of this. That is sigma x square will be the variance, and hence we can find the other thing. Except for that, everything is just the same. So sigma x square is ex square minus mu x square. Sigma x square minus mu x square is 37.9 square, and sigma x square is 13.3 square. So this quantity will be this in addition with this added together. So if you add them, you'll get 1542.5. as the value of E of X square. Then E of Y will be E of whatever is the given for Y, that is 0.6 X square plus 7.9 X plus 107.1. If you try to write it, then the constant will come out, and E of X square plus 7.x is again constant, and E of X plus 107.1. The expectation of a constant will be the constant itself. That's why we are writing here 107.1 itself, whatever was that here. So this value we have found out 1542.5. This value also we have found out 37.9. And this value we will get it as 107.1. So if you multiply all that and simplify, you'll get 13.3201 if you want. Then we go for the question number 41. Question number 41, if you see over here, is verify the 2.56 that E of z cube is equal to 0, where z is the normalized Gaussian random variable. And then find E of x cube, where x is equal to sigma xz plus mu x. Okay, in place of writing z is equal to x minus mu x by sigma x, we are writing this, that's all, not much of a difference. Okay, however, the need is to find this and check whether this is equal to 0. So to check whether this is equal to 0, we'll go to the problem there. So E z cube is equal to 1 by 2 pi integral minus infinity z cube e to the power of minus z squared by 2 dz. So if you do integration by parts, you can choose the u equal to z square, and dv is equal to z e to the power of minus z squared by 2 dz. So du will become 2 into z squared's differentiation will become 2z dz. And the integration of this will become minus e to the power of minus z squared by 2. Minus e to the power of minus z squared by 2. Then e of z cube will be equal to, we can just write the, you know, what you call formula, that is integral u v dash is equal to u v minus integral v u dash. Okay, so u v dash will be whatever we have here, u v is this, so therefore we'll get z square e to the power of minus z square by 2 with limits minus infinity to plus infinity, and integral of the v into, you know, du is what we have, so therefore we are writing this. So now this quantity will be, if you substitute the limits, you apply the L'Hospital rule and substitute the limits, this will be equal to 0. Okay, the second term will be, again you can see that it is z into this quantity, 2 is always there, 2 you can take out, z into this quantity will give us the odd value, so the integrand is an odd thing over here, that's why it is 0, so therefore 0 minus 0 will give us the value 0 itself. So e of x square, x cube we need to find, where x is sigma xz plus mu x. So therefore we'll write cube here, all that cube, we are writing the formula and expanding it. Okay, sigma square x cube z cube plus mu x cube plus 3, this quantity square multiplied by this quantity, then 3 into this quantity divided by this quantity square, all that we can simplify and write it. So therefore you can just take this out, this is a constant here, so we'll get sigma x cube e of z cube plus, this is again a constant here, therefore expectation of constant will be the same quantity, right? Here the variable is only the z square, all the other things are constant, therefore we're taking it out, e of z square. Again, the variable here is z only, therefore rest of things are taken out, we have left with ez. Now ez cube we have found it to be 0, ez is also 0 for, this is the mean for the, you know, standard standard, so to say, Gaussian you know, distributions mean, okay, that will be equal to 0, okay, normalized or standard. So we are left with this is equal to 1 for the, this is the, what you call, this is equal to the mean squared as well as the, what you call, variance, right? So that will be equal to 1. We know that value equal to 1 for normalized Gaussian random variable. So therefore we are writing 1 over here. This we are writing 0. So we are left with this and only this term. That is what we have written. This will be again 0. Therefore we are not writing that. So this is the final solution. Then 42. So if you see 42 here, verify 2.57, that is e of z to the power 4 is equal to 3, where z is normalized Gaussian random variable. So again, normalized Gaussian random variable, e z to the power 4 is what we need to find out. So to find out that, Here we have 1 by 2 pi integral minus infinity z to the power 4 e to the power minus z squared by 2 dz. So integration by parts is u is equal to z cube, 1 less than the z to the 4. The other is z is taken out here, z e to the power minus z squared by 2 dz. So again, du will be 3z square dz. U is this, differential of this will be du, differential of this will be 3z square dz. And dv is given as this, so therefore the integration of this dv will be e to the power minus z squared by 2. So e of z squared is again, you can write integral, you know, u v dash is equal to u v minus integral v u dash. So we are writing the same thing over here, that is, you know, u v this into this with limits minus infinity. And integral of this into this is what we are writing over here. So this quantity turns out to be zero. Again, L'Hospital rule you can apply and get it. And we'll get here the 3 common, and we can take it out. So we get 3 by 2 pi, and then we'll try to do the integration by part for this. So if you do that, again you can write u is equal to z. dv is equal to z e to the power of minus z squared by 2. So du will be equal to dz itself, since u is equal to dz. V is equal to minus e to the power of minus z squared by 2. So again, uv minus vu dash integral, okay? Same thing. So whatever was there, here 3 by 2 pi, we are taking it out. So we'll get this quantity. Again, this quantity will be zero, which will be just this multiplied by this with the limits minus infinity to infinity. Then integral, this multiplied by this with the limits minus infinity to infinity. So we'll get this quantity over here. If you simplify, minus minus will cancel, and we are going to get this, and that is nothing but 1 equal to the value 1. 3 into 1 will be equal to 3. So thus we can get the answer. 43 is the next question. 43, if you see over here, right? 43 is the CD of for the Rayleigh random variable is given in the appendix A as shown here, where B is positive constant. Verify that PDF mean and variance given in the appendix A are correct. So to find the PDF, we need to differentiate this with respect to R. Random variable is capital R. Small r will be the outcome. So we need to, you know, small f, capital R, small r. We need to find out, that is the, you know, PDF. And that is by differentiating this equation. Then again, rest is same thing, PDF, you know, mean, variance and all that. Similarly, if you see 44 and 45 also give you the, you know, similar type of 44, 45, even 46 also. I don't know whether the other things also will be similar. If you see the, you know, next page. Okay, before going to the next page, let us try to solve that. Oh, PDF has got closed somehow. I don't know why. So I hope you are able to catch me. Okay, 43 is what we are solving. So Rayleigh's random, you know, variable distribution with the CDF value given over here. So you just differentiate this. If you try to differentiate this here, differential of 1 will be 0. Differential of the exponential function will be the same exponential function with the what you call the value which is given over here, that is the internal derivative of this quantity. The internal derivative of this quantity is minus 2r by b. So minus minus will cancel, then we are left with 2r by b multiplied by this quantity. And the other one is other one for r less than 0 is 0. So even if you differentiate, nothing is going to happen. So this is 2r by b exponential minus r squared by b. So then we need to find the mean for this. To find the mean, we need to write mu r equal to integral minus infinity small r fr r dr. Okay, so in whatever was there, we have that r and fr r we have here, which we have found out 2r by b. So therefore, we'll get 2r squared by b exponential minus r squared by b dr. So again, integrating by parts, u is equal to r and dv is equal to 2r by b exponential minus r squared by b dr. So differential of this will be du is equal to dr, and the integral of this will be v is equal to minus of e to the power of minus r squared by b, because we already have the differential of this quantity over here. Okay, so this again you can try to substitute this, you will get the value which is 0, and hence we are just left with the other quantity over here, right? So in this you can just try to write r squared by b is equal to x squared by 2, so that you know we'll have minus x squared by 2 over here, which is the standard format for the Gaussian only half of the Gaussian, because we are having here 0 to infinity. So therefore we'll get that. So if you substitute this, then we'll get r squared is equal to b by 2 x squared, and hence r will be root of b by 2 x, so dr will be root of b by 2 dx. So if you substitute all that, you'll get the mu r will be equal to 0 to infinity e to the power of minus x squared by 2 root of b by 2 dx. So root of b by 2 you can take out, and this quantity you can write, it is the one-sided Gaussian, only 50% of it. So therefore, otherwise this quantity will be root of 2 pi, but if you divide it by 2, you'll get root of pi by 2. Okay, root of pi by 2. So if you try to solve this, you'll get root of pi b by 4. Pi b by 4. Okay, which is given in the appendix also, right? Which is given the appendix also. So if you see the appendix for the Rayleigh distribution, this is exponential, Laplace, Pascal. Okay, so here you have mu r is equal to root of pi b by 4. Similarly, we need to find the variance, right? To find the variance, we need to first find the square of the mean. This is not mean, this is rather this is not variance, this is mean of the square of random variable. So that is r squared f r r dr. So you'll get 2r cubed by b exponential minus r squared by b dr. So again, integrating by parts, you can take u is equal to r squared, dv is equal to 2r by b exponential minus r squared by b dr. So the differential of this will be 2r dr. The integral of this will be the value minus exponential minus r squared by b, because internal derivative of this is minus of 2r by b. We have 2r by b here, so only minus is not there, that's why it's coming out here. So again, the integration by parts is integral u dv is equal to uv minus integral v du. So the values will be again here. You can just try to write that uv is this multiplied by this with the limits. Vu dash or vdu is multiplication of these two with the integral over here, and you'll get this. So again, the first term is zero. According to the L-Hospital rule, we have to apply. That is this divided by e to the power of plus r squared by b, it will become, and you can apply the L-Hospital. You'll get the value zero. So always in most of the problems, you'll get this value as zero. So you need not bother much about it. Just write equal to zero. So then 0 to infinity 2r, this is only between the positive quantity. For r less than 0, it is, you know, 0. Therefore, we are writing here 0 to infinity, not minus infinity to plus infinity. So therefore, here we'll get 2r minus of minus is, will cancel, 2r exponential minus r squared by b dr. So you have already the internal part of the internal derivative, because internal derivative of this is minus of 2r by b. We already have a 2r, therefore what is left is b. So minus b exponential r squared by b with limits 0 and infinity. So if you substitute infinity, you'll get the value 0, e to the power of minus infinity is 0. If you substitute 0, you'll get the value 1 with a minus sign. So minus minus will cancel and we are left with just plus. So the variance will be the mean of the square minus square of the mean. Mean of the square minus square of the mean. So b minus pi b by 4, that is 4 pi b by 4. And this is already there in the, you know, Rayleigh distribution also, which is given in the appendix over here. So same thing, 4 minus pi b by 4. So similarly, we can try to solve the other problems which are there below that. Similar problems rather. So we are trying to solve the, what you call, 43, which is this. Here we have Laplace. Again, same method, differentiate, take the mean, find the variance after finding the mean of the square. Similarly, for 45, gamma variable. For 46, Cauchy's. Sometimes the mean and all might not exist in some of the cases, so therefore we need to be a little careful there. Okay, then 47, we have already solved this. This is a simple problem. Okay, but still, let us try to do that also. So, 47. I'm left with 3 pages, right? You have any doubts till now? Oh, there are. Some people have put in the chat box. No, only yes is there. So no doubts. So I might go into the rollover into the next session for some of the other problems, which are hardly some 3 pages, because I don't think 3 minutes will be sufficient for that, right? So we'll roll over for the next session for the other problems also. We might hardly take 10-15 minutes. So I'll stop this, rejoin. I'll just stop this, just rejoin the, okay, because again, there will be a lot of discontinuity.